نتعرف اليوم على ألفريدو كوتيت، وهو دكتور بالهندسة المعمارية، سابقا كان سيناتور وحاليا هو رئيس الغرفة التجارية البرازيلية اللبنانية. خلينا سوا نتعرف على الشخصية البارزة.
Mr. Alfredo Cotet, thank you for receiving us here in your offices in Sao Paulo. I know you are the ex-senator and also the president of the Brazil-Lebanon Chamber of Commerce. You were born here in Sao Paulo in 1947 after your father emigrated from Majayun in 1918. Tell us more about the immigration story.
Well, first of all, Karen, it's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you.
And you know Karen Bustani. I don't know if you know, we have an ambassador in Paris, mm-hmm. José Maurício Bustani. I don't know if he is your relative or not, but you are a good ambassador from Brazil.
Thank you. He's not a relative, but I know him, and I thank you.
Good. Well, I am here to answer your question. And I was born here in São Paulo in 1947. My father immigrated from Lebanon in 1918. And my mother is also from Lebanese descendant. She was born here in Brazil, in São Paulo also. But my grandparents are also from Majayun. I have all my my life here in Brazil, in São Paulo. But I have one, my heart is from Lebanon, because my parents, also my father and my mother, every time talk about Lebanon and also what Lebanon is, and this I create some identification with Lebanon.
It's important. So I see how much you are attached to Lebanon. Why did your father immigrated to Brazil? Did he have some relatives here?
Well, you know, in that time, is in before the First War, many people immigration from Lebanon. Our Emperor Pedro II visited Lebanon and invited people to come to see Brazil and maybe to stay in Brazil. In that time, many, many Lebanese, they come to Brazil and stay. One of them is my grandfather. Mm-hmm. He went here in Brazil maybe 19, or about the first decade of the 19th
century.
And then he started to work here. Then he called my father to come. My father also studied in Lebanon in 10 or 11 years. But my grandfather has also children here, more three boys and three girls.
Here
they was born here in Brazil.
Yeah, and as you said, your mother is from Lebanese descent. Your father met her here in Sao Paulo.
Yes,
because she was born here, but
yes,
from Lebanese parents.
Yes. They met.
So you are Lebanese from both sides?
Both sides.
Yeah.
And both sides from Majayun.
I know that you have a sister. Tell us more about your childhood. Did you fight with your sister? Were you friends? What are your memories, the best memories you have from your childhood?
Well, it's one good childhood. We have one in the beginning of the 15th. It's something like a quiet country, good country to stay. My sister and I, we are very close. And many friends, good schools to study, and well, you have a good education.
Yeah.
And also what the traditional of Lebanese, the food, the culture, the my father and my mother, every time they talk Arabic, and I have some Arabic in my ear.
In your ear. They used to speak Arabic in your presence.
Yes, mm-hmm. Every time.
Every time. And you learned some words. Yeah. And when you were a kid, you had some Brazilian friends, of course, but did you have some Lebanese friends too?
Well, the first thing that my father did is to be associated in Club Monte Libano,
mm-hmm.
Mountain Lebanon Club. And there we have many, many friends from Lebanese descendant. And also today is the biggest club in São Paulo.
Indeed.
Well, you know, Monte Libano is the biggest club here in São Paulo, is the biggest Lebanese club. And there I can find many, many peoples of Lebanese descendant. And they, in there I have many friends from there.
You hold a degree in civil engineering and a PhD in economics. How do you find universities in Sao Paulo? Did you get a good experience in education?
Well, we have here many good schools, many good universities. I studied in the Mackenzie College. It's an American university. It's the same. It's like the American University in Beirut,
mm-hmm.
is the same style of the education.
The same system, yeah.
The same system. And after I graduation in civil engineer, I have a PhD, PhD in economic, in another school, the main administration school of Brazil. The Fundação Getúlio Vargas.
Mm-hmm. And you were satisfied?
Yes.
Yes. ولد الفريدو كوتيت سنة 1947 بساو باولو من بعد ما هاجروا أهله من لبنان بأوائل القرن العشرين وهو حائز على دكتوراه بالهندسة المدنية من جامعة ساو باولو. تتعرفوا أكثر عن حياته المهنية وشخصيته المميزة خليكم معنا من بعد البريك.
Sem você não tem primavera, ó minha flor. Não tem rosa mais bonita, meu amor. Uou, é todo seu. Quando você não vem, eu fico louco de vontade de te ver. Hey, é você que pode me fazer muito feliz. Teu amor, o teu calor. Eu sempre quis. Hey, é você. Pode me fazer muito feliz. Teu amor, o teu calor. É tudo que eu sempre quis.
Mr. Alfredo, I would love to talk about your career because you have reached great positions. When you graduated, you first worked as an employee in many construction companies. Then you decided to establish your own company in 1973, and it's Ingetecnica.
Right.
Tell us more about it.
Well, when I finished my civil engineer career, I started to work in a construction company. 5 years later, I decided to have my own company. I founded with a partner. His name is Ricardo Huri, also from Lebanese descendant. Mm-hmm. We studied in the same university. And well, we start to run our own company. This is 40 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he and I, we are in the council, and my son is the CEO of our company. My son has 32 years old,
mm-hmm.
And you know, I have two boys, and both work with me here in the company.
Ah, okay.
The older is the CEO. His name is Guilherme Cotait, and the younger is Alfredo Cotait, the son.
Junior.
Junior.
Yeah.
And he is from market. He study market. Well, we are now working hard.
I know that you have achieved many projects, such as hotels and schools and hospitals.
Well, in these 40 years, I did many construction. I did 2 million square meters of construction. I did hospital, hotels, schools, residential building, commercial building, and you know, Karen, the hotel that you stay here in São Paulo, I did it.
Yes, you
did. Built
very beautiful hotel.
This, this building.
Yes, yes. Thank you. We thank you. I know that you are a member of the Trade Association since 1981, and you were elected vice president in 1999. I want you to tell us more about its activities.
Well, you know, we have our professional working, and also we have many others works to do, like a voluntary member. One of them is in our trade association. I was member since 1981 and elected vice president since 1999.
Yeah.
It's one good institution here in São Paulo, one of the best commercial institution. We have, you know, we have here in São Paulo 3,000 members, and in all the state of São Paulo, more of 200 entities. Is the biggest trade association in Brazil.
Yeah, as Sao Paulo is the biggest city.
It's the biggest city.
Yes. And in 2001, you were elected the president of the Brazilian-Lebanese Chamber of Commerce.
Yes.
And I think it was a hard task because it was nearly dead before you came. What are the activities you took over?
Well, Karen, you know better than I. In Lebanon, has one bad time since 1975
of course.
Until 1990. And our chamber have some relations with Lebanon. And this, in that time, everything stopped. Then the people here in the people of our Lebanese community decide to invite me to be the new president, because I am a new young people, to promote and restart the chamber here in São Paulo. Then I start my job. We did many things, but the most important thing is our trip to Lebanon. Visit Lebanon is our first step. And since 1990, we did several trips to Lebanon. I love Lebanon.
And what is the role of the Brazil-Lebanon Chamber of Commerce, especially regarding the activities between Lebanon and Brazil?
I don't know if you know, Karen, but here in Brazil, we have about 10 million Lebanese descendants. And we need to put these people in touch with the Lebanese people.
Of course.
And the second point is trade. When we start our work, our trade is about less $100 million. Now it's about $300 million, the balance of our trade, Lebanon and Brazil. But we need to do more. We also want to have in Lebanon one platform to export products of Brazil, not only to Lebanon, but to the Arab country and also help Lebanon to export their products to Brazil.
Yeah, this is important.
This is very important. International trade is something is from two hands. We need to help also the Lebanese companies to export to Brazil. And also we are working in other issues, like now we have a project to build a cultural center, mm-hmm. Lebanese cultural center here in São Paulo. We are making this project, and maybe we are going to try to start to build it next year.
This is so interesting.
Yeah, Karen, the paper of our chamber is to facilitate trade with Lebanon. And in this case, when I am in the Senate, National Senate, I promote a project to have a free area of trade between Mercosur and Lebanon. We are working this time in this issue. I hope in the future we can do it.
Yes, very interesting. I know that you were elected as a senator in 2002. Tell us, what are the responsibilities of a senator here in Brazil?
You know, Karen, here in Brazil, we have 27 states, and each state elected 3 senators. Then we are 81 senators. Mm-hmm. We are senators from defend the state. I was senator from São Paulo. My work is defending the state of São Paulo. But in this case, I did many things, included the project of create the free area trade of trade between Lebanon and Brazil, and also to put the image of Lebanon in the national scenario. Many times I go to the to speak, to make a speech, and to put Lebanon and promote Lebanon. This is my job with Lebanon. And also, in other times, in the Chamber of Commerce, yeah. We also did many missions to Lebanon. The first mission, we promote the visit of President Lula to Lebanon.
Yeah.
The first president of Brazil after our Imperial Dom Pedro II, who visit Lebanon. After we promote the mission with our governor of the state of São Paulo, Geraldo Alckmin. Mm-hmm. In the end, we promote the visit of our mayor of the city of São Paulo, our Lebanese descendant, Gilberto Kassab. Mm-hmm.
Yes, the ex-mayor of São Paulo. Yes. I know that you have written a book, you have published a book about your experience as a senator, including everything you had during the 8 years. Tell us more about this book.
Well, it's a summary of what I did in the Senate. And I'm sorry, it's in Portuguese, then I can give you, maybe I can translate where I begin next time.
Thank you.
But it's something only to have some recordation about what I did there. But the one of the pieces in my book is a speech of the Independence Day of Lebanon. When I went to the Tribune and make one speech about the 67th anniversary of Lebanon in 22 of November 2010.
Yes, 3 years ago.
3 years ago.
Yes, because not a long time ago, we celebrated the 70th anniversary.
Yeah, 70 now is 22 of November.
Yes.
November 22, some days ago.
Yeah.
وصل ألفريدو كوتيت إلى مناصب مهمة جداً، سابقاً كان سيناتور وحالياً رئيس غرفة التجارة البرازيلية اللبنانية. لتعرفوا أكثر عن حياته العائلية تابعونا بعد البريك.
I would love to talk about your family now that we've heard your great story about your great career. I know that your wife passed away a few years ago, and it was a great love story, and you have two sons, and I would love you to talk about her if you don't mind.
No, of course.
How you met her and your love story.
Yes, she's a beautiful and wonderful lady from Lebanese descendant. I knew her on Monte Libano in 1970, and we married in 1979. We have two boys. She's a wonderful person. She gave a good education to my sons. She is a lady, do many things to our society, to the Lebanese
community,
the Lebanese institution. She made many works. One of these works in a Lebanese institution who take care of the old people is one important institution here in São Paulo. And another who take care of the children.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a great work that she did. What means saudades? Do you know, Karin, who is saudades? Saudades is a Brazilian word that can say, I miss her.
I have
many saudades of her.
Of course, of course. Yeah. She supported you a lot in your career.
Of course.
She was behind
every time.
You.
It's
a good wife, a good mother, yeah,
good person.
I know that you also stood by her when she was sick, and you tried all your best to find a cure
of
for
course,
her.
Of course, of course.
These were very difficult years.
Yes, it's 5 years.
Would you like to talk a bit about
it? Yes, we passed 5 years. It's very, very difficult. We went to United States to make the treatment. With we have doctors here in São Paulo, but also we have another doctor in the United States who take care of her. And you know, the family of my wife had a hospital, mm-hmm. and of course the hospital. Made all the treatment of her in here in São Paulo. But you know, it's a pity.
Yes, of course. This is life.
It's life.
It's yes. life. And did your life change after she passed away?
Of course.
You
of
are
course.
Not the same.
No, of course change. My social life changed. My, you know, I never went in a supermarket. Now I need to do the supermarket, I need to take care of our house, to see how the maids take care of our house. And also, my two boys are my now the main responsibility to see them and to follow the career of them.
Mm. I even heard that you stayed like a year after she passed away, refusing to see maybe your friends, and you were like isolating yourself.
You know, Karen, when we are a couple, we have many friends, but couple friends. Then we don't have more of the contact with these couples because the life change, and I need to follow and to see another style of of life. Mm-hmm. It's not easy.
Of course.
Look, it's not easy.
Of course. I'm sure she's watching over you from up the skies.
Of course.
Of course. Let us talk about your two boys. I know you are proud of them. You said that they are both working in your company.
Both working with me here.
Yeah.
The older is the CEO, and today I am in the council, but when he needs in the operation, I am an employee of him.
Yes, and you always talk about your Lebanese origins, so they are attached to Lebanon as much as you are?
Yes, well, I told you that several times we went to Lebanon. I take my two sons to Lebanon twice, and they now often they go to Lebanon from themselves.
Ah, nice.
It's
to know.
Something incredible.
Yes.
How I can transmit my
passion
to Lebanon to them.
Okay.
I will work here in our cultural center. The main point that I defend is to tell the young people how is important our origin, how is important to know how our parents come to Brazil, the history, and how is important to go to see Lebanon. When you can go one time to Lebanon, you are going to return many times.
Yeah.
This is the one special point that I want to tell you, to your telespectadores, and this is something important. The first visit are not only going to be the unique,
yes,
are going to be the first of several visits.
Yes, yes. I am happy to see your passion towards Lebanon. I'm really glad. And we'll talk about Lebanon. What does family mean to you, especially that today you're playing both roles, the father and the mother?
Well, it's a difficult moment. You know, when I had my wife, she take care of all. We have many dinners, maybe one or two days of per week. We have received many, many persons. We have one good house. I built it.
Yourself.
Thinking about her and maybe my grand
children.
And now everything this stop.
But you will have grandchildren.
Maybe, I don't know.
No,
I am waiting.
Yeah, I'm sure they will get married soon.
But this is on her dream.
Mm.
And now I am continuing my life, take care of the history, her history, take care of our house. And that I told you, doing many things that I never did. And also, you know, My life was working, traveling. I never see many things that I am seeing now.
Mm-hmm. And you are close to your sons?
Very close.
Very close.
Very close. Mm-hmm. Is my main responsibility now. Mm. And well, we have one good family.
Yes,
I'm very happy.
I can see. Alfredo Cotet متزوج وعنده ولدين وكلنا تأثرنا بقصة الحب اللي عيشها مع زوجته اللي ماتت. تتعرفوا أكثر عن علاقته بلبنان؟ تابعونا بعد البريك. Now I will talk about your passion, which is Lebanon. And I see that through the interview, you were all the time talking about Lebanon, though it's the main part now. I would love to know if you have still relatives in Marjayoun.
Well, my aunt and my uncle who lived in Marjayoun, they died. But I have cousins in Beirut. We also have a house and a piece of land in Marjayoun.
Mm, nice.
My cousin take care of this house.
I may say you are the only Brazilian of Lebanese descent that I've interviewed in Brazil who has a piece of land in Lebanon. And I'm proud of that. I'm proud of you.
But you know, I have a cousin here, a doctor, Dr. Raul Kutai.
Yeah.
And one time we are in Lebanon and we visit together our house in Marjayoun. And we discussed the possibility to make one museum of the history of our family in Marjayoun. We are going to do one museum in the ground floor,
mm-hmm.
and the first floor, two rooms with bath to the people, go there and stay one night.
Mm-hmm.
We start to do this project, but stop. Everything in Lebanon, I don't know, stop.
Yes.
But one day are going to do it.
Yes, it's an unstable country.
Unstable, yes.
Yes, and when you go to Marjayoun, you are surely warmly welcomed. Isn't it?
Of course, all my parents, family, all my relatives are there. Many families. I don't know if you know, but we have a club here, the Marjayoun Club.
No.
Also, yes.
Yeah. It's, as you already told us, you have visited Lebanon many, many times, and always with Mr. Guilherme Motar.
Oh, you know, every time. When I went to Lebanon, sometimes I went with my family,
mm-hmm.
my wife, my two boys, my mother,
mm-hmm.
my aunt. But other times I went with the chamber. And the leader of this trip to Lebanon, it's a man who loves Lebanon more than I. He is Guilherme Mata.
Yes, yes.
A great
Lebanese Brazilian.
Yes, a special person, a great Lebanese Brazilian, also, and I think he's here in Brazil today. The person who has more identification with Lebanon.
Yes, indeed, I had the pleasure and honor to meet. With him, and he speaks great French and great English, and he communicated his passion to Lebanon to me too. Yeah, And do you have some projects today with the near future with Lebanon?
Of course. Well, every year we have three times to promote missions to Lebanon. Mm-hmm. In the beginning of the year, we went with some authority from Brazil to Lebanon. In July, one social group to have more contact.
Mm. And as I knew that you went once to attend the marathon in Beirut, and you took with you like 300 people from Brazil.
Yes, yes. This is maybe 6 years ago. Mm-hmm. And all these people was young people, mm-hmm. and they liked very much Lebanon.
Mm-hmm. Nice. These were Brazilians or Brazilians from Lebanese descent?
Brazilian of Lebanese descendant, and Lebanese people who lives here in Brazil.
Yeah. Mr. Alfredo, do you have a last word to all the Lebanese viewers who are watching us tonight from Lebanon and from all over the world?
Well, Karim, you know, here in Brazil, we have maybe 10 million Lebanese descendants. Maybe our diaspora is three times more. We need to have one network of our diaspora with the Lebanese people in Lebanon. This is important because we want to be more close with the, not only the diaspora, but also with the Lebanese people. We need to put these people in touch. In Brazil, this is my mission. I want to do it. And also, it is important the people and the government of Lebanon to know and to help us to do it.
I hope your message will be conveyed to the Lebanese government tonight, and I really hope to see you soon in Lebanon, not only as the president of the Brazil-Lebanon Chamber of Commerce, but especially as a Lebanese citizen.
Well, Karen, thank you, and inshallah, I will be there soon.
تعرفنا اليوم على ألفريدو كوتيت، هالإنسان اللي واجه كتير من الصعوبات بحياته ولكن بالمثابرة قدر يحقق كتير من النجاحات.
Todo el mundo abre el paso porque pasa un bardo y todo el mundo ya lo está cantando. Seguro que la mami que está bailando este tema sabroso le está gustando. Pone sexy cuerpo, goza como tú quieras, go.
إذا بدكم تعرفوا أكثر عن هالحلقة أو عن ألفريدو كوتيت، ما تنسوا تتابعونا على مواقع التواصل الاجتماعي. وما تنسوا تحضرونا الأسبوع القادم بنفس الوقت لتكتشفوا اسم جديد من أسماء من التاريخ.